their families.
Yes, they did, Kathy. After three anxiety and tear-filled days, some Chinese families here have reached loved ones by phone or the internet. The emotional ties here are strong as a growing number of people from China live in Milwaukee because business with the U.S. has grown.
The huge glass wall was shaking to such a degree that she thought it was going to shatter.
UW-Milwaukee teaching assistant Ian Mei-Qiang and fellow TA Qin look at pictures of earthquake damage in China. Ian Mei tells the story of her aunt in China escaping from the ninth floor of an office building in one of the cities within miles of the epicenter.
And they slept in their car and spent some of the time just on the street, sitting there or lying on a comforter.
Just last year, Qin graduated from a university in the earthquake region, and she finally talked with family and friends.
My schoolmate, because I graduated from Chengdu, my schoolmate told me the building, our dormitory, was broken. And they all went to the ground to sleep there.
For Ian Mei, after 3 days of trying to reach her relatives, this morning, success and relief.
She told me also this morning that it is quite difficult at this time to find bottled water and, you know, instant noodles, which is a very common food for Chinese people.
As Ian Mei's daughter plays piano in their Milwaukee home, she thinks of all the children killed or orphaned in China.
And my father said, tears and sighs don't help. Do something.
There is a growing effort in the U.S. to do something, to send money to help earthquake victims. Some 30 major U.S. corporations, from Microsoft to Walmart, are donating millions of dollars for relief efforts. Kathy and Toya.